Everyone, good afternoon. I keep thinking it's morning. It is afternoon now. My name is Miss Linnea or Miss L. Welcome to Beginning Ballet. So we're only going to be doing ballet today. Make sure you have the correct footwear for your floor at home. Make sure you have a water bottle nearby. And we'll be doing ballet bar today. So make sure you have something that you can use as a ballet bar, either a chair or a countertop or a wall, just something you can hold on to for balance, and you can still see what I'm doing. Also, if this is a good class for you, I teach this same level on Monday and Wednesday, and we'll be continuously working on the same thing. So if you want like that routine, if you love ballet, you need to improve, taking both of those classes every week is gonna be awesome. In addition to any other classes that you want to take throughout the week. Let's get started on the floor. So take a seat in the middle of your space and sit crisscross applesauce. I'm going to turn on our music and I will meet you on the floor. Here we go. Sit up really tall. Imagine that string is pulling you from the top of your head. We're gonna work again, just like Monday, we're gonna be working on spotting and turning today, doing some chaînés and things like that. So, good day to be in class. Here we go. Crisscross applesauce, up and down. Look, up and down. And take that side to side. Sitting tall, tummy is tight. To the shoulder, take it over and over without lifting the shoulders. It's all about your neck. Lengthening, stretching, good. Now swing side to side. Swing, swing from the bottom. Good, turn that to a head roll all the way around. Again, head roll. Other way, reverse it. Last time. All right, now shoulders, we go up and down. Squeeze, up, release. Two more. Last one. Good, now roll those shoulders front to back. Front to back, two more. Open your chest. Last one, good. Big rainbow, reach forward. Drop your head. Relax everything down. And let's walk those hands over to the diagonal, nose to your knee. Should feel a nice stretch in your low back. And walk it over to that other diagonal. Excuse me. And let's sit up tall, fingertips on the floor. Let's do some side bends. Waiting for our music, here we go. Up and over, other side, up and over. Keep your bottom on the floor. Two more, last one. All righty, good. Let's bring the bottoms of our feet together. Sit up tall, trying to bring your feet as close to your body as you can and still sitting tall. Now we're gonna round or hinge with a flat back forward, whichever you prefer today. Opening up the hips, you can even grab your feet and press your elbows to push down your legs. That's another way to deepen this stretch. Good, and coming up, let's take those legs out in front of you. Stick straight, point your toes down to the floor, and we flex up to the ceiling, point down to the floor. Try to roll through your feet, roll through your ankles. And last time, rolling through. Good, one of each. Let's switch and switch, switch and switch. How hard can you point those toes? Ballet is all about that point, all the time. Good, now roll your ankles out, out. Good, let's reverse that. Let's go in. Maybe one day soon we could go over some exercises with a TheraBand to strengthen your feet and increase that arch. If that sounds good to you, maybe you could email the studio or do a little chat right now and let me know if that's something that you would like to do.
Reach, reach, reach.
And if you don't have a TheraBand at home, you can also use a towel. And flex your feet one more time.
Reach forward.
Good. And let's open up to our straddle. Point your toes. Make sure those kneecaps are facing directly up to the ceiling, not rolling in. Okay.
And reach your arms forward.
Ideally, you have your tummy on the floor, but we're not all built like that, are we? Searches.
Reach, reach, reach. And coming up,
let's take our nose to a knee. Just pick a side.
Take it over. And sitting up tall, let's try the other side.
Nose towards that knee. Hands on either side of the leg, both hips down. And coming up, let's take some side bends, reach up and over. Open your chest here, open, open. Another side, up and over, big opening through the chest. And let's try one more time, reach forward. Maybe you go a little further this time. And coming up, let's swing our legs around behind us, coming onto your tummy, hands under your shoulders, big cobra stretch up, opening through the chest, shoulders down, and lower back down one more time, big press up, and here you can bend your toes to your head, or you can reach for your top of your feet and pull yourself up, yeah, whichever one works for you today. Give it a try. And then come on down. Let's press up to tabletop. Tabletop position. You're going to round your spine.
Gazing under and then arch your back,
looking up to the ceiling. And again, round. And arch. Last time. Big round. And arch, come to a neutral spine, and take the toes side to side. This is gonna reset your spine. And pull your hips back. Today, let's reach back for those heels. Pull yourself back a little further. Drop your head down.
Good, and here we go.
Slowly rolling up. Let's come up to the knees. We're gonna do our splits. Yeah, splits day. So take your right foot forward. Point your toes, hands to the floor. Slowly slide toward that split stretch. Oh my goodness. Just breathe into it. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Cheating, no cheating. I can't see you, but let's try that left side, leg out, hands to the floor, slide. If this is feeling really good, really easy, you can take your arms up. That will help you sink a little bit deeper into the stretch. Sometimes I like to bring my hands on the inside and get my inner thigh. And carefully come out of that. Middle splits, you're gonna stand. Take your legs out wide, hands to the floor, and slide to that middle split. You guys are gonna do it, I am not. Just hold it, just a few more counts. Big breath into it. I know. Breathe, breathe, breathe. And carefully come out of that. Okay, good. Carefully come up to standing, very gracefully. We're gonna head over to our ballet bar. So I'm gonna grab my bar. If you have a chair or something, you can use as your support. Now is the time. And as I keep saying, if your support, if you feel like if you face your bar and you feel like you might kick it, feel free to take one hand to that bar, other hand to your hip, and you can do everything with both legs, just with one hand, okay? But since I'm not gonna kick that bar, I'm gonna have my two hands on the bar for our beginning ballet class. We're gonna do almost everything from first here, and let's try to get through a few exercises like we did on Monday, and then we will come center and do our turning and stuff. So I may do a little bit longer bar today. Let's start facing the bar. Let's go right into pliés today. So first position, both hands to your support, unless of course you need to just have one hand. We'll take two demi-pliés, one grand plié with a flat back, two demi-pliés, and let's take our arch back, okay, like we did on Monday. So you're gonna just turn your head to one side, big cambré up and over. Then let's open up to second position, two demis, one grand plié, keeping your heels down, two more demis, and then a really upper curve, upper C curve forward. Okay, after that, we're gonna do a big side bend from side to side, taking your time. And then at the end, we're gonna plié relevé, test your balance in second position. Okay, I'm gonna be doing everything with you. Just follow along. First position, two hands on your support, if you can. Here we go. Nice and slow. So stand up tall, drop that tailbone down, tummy is engaged tight. Take that demi-plié. Your heels stay pressing together, pressing down into the floor. Until, of course, your grand plié, they have to come up just a little bit, but they press right back down to the floor. Two more demi-pliés. Squeeze your inner thighs, squeeze your butt. Demi-plié. Stretch. Now let's take a cambré up and over for the upper back. Opening to second position. Squeeze those rotators. Squeeze your turnout muscles. Grand plié in second. Heels stay on the floor. Don't lean forward. Don't pull too far back. Two more demi-pliés. Demi-plié. Squeeze your inner thighs. And stretch forward, just your upper body, for a high curve. Okay, right arm, side bend, up and over. Looking down. Good, other side, left arm, up and over. Good, let's take a few relevés. So plié, relevé, plié, relevé. One more. This one you will hold in your balance. Tummy, belly button in, drop that tailbone down, open your chest, energy goes upward. Make sure those legs are straight, heels are high. Good, demi-plié, tendu back to first position. Okie dokie. So, something I wanna talk about that's important to learn even at your age is that you have to squeeze your muscles. It's not enough to bend and straighten your legs. That is doing nothing for you, really. It's not doing much. So you have to start to learn how to engage your muscles, squeeze them. It's the difference between this and this. Yeah, that your muscles are working. That's how you're gonna get those beautiful, defined, shaped arms and legs, you know, that beautiful dancer body that everybody wants. You have to squeeze your muscles for it. And that's how you're gonna get stronger. That's how you're gonna be able to stand on one leg, turn on one leg, balance, yeah? Okay, cool. That was just a side note. Let's do tendus from first. So again, facing your bar, first position, we always start with the right leg, then we go to the left. For some of you, I might be repeating myself a lot, but that's because I want this information to go way into your brain forever and ever and ever. So when you're 95 years old, oh yeah, in ballet class, you always start with the right foot and then you go left, okay? It needs to be ingrained in there always. So with your right foot, tendu front and flex. Turn in, turn out. Tendu and close. One more and close. Okay, woo, what just happened? We go to the side. Tendu and flex. Turn it in, turn it out. Tendu and close. One more and close. We do that front side, back side on quad. Back and a flex. Turn it in, turn it out. Point and close and point and close. Last time and flex. Turn it in, turn it out. And point and close, point and close. Then we will repeat everything on the left side. No balance on this one, just right and left. So today your rotation is going to be with a flexed foot. Rotate in, rotate out. Notice you're not lifting the hip to rotate. It's in that hip socket, okay? I love to talk about that. This is your hip joint moves in a circular motion, just like your shoulders, right? It's called circumduction. So that rotation, especially to the back, don't take the whole leg with you, right? It's just in that hip socket, okay? It's gonna warm up that hip socket for getting those legs up higher and all that stuff. Okay, tendus from first. And I'm talking a lot today, I don't know why. Because I had coffee, that's why. Here we go, right foot, go front. Flex, rotate in, out. Point, close, tendu, close. Good, again to the side. Rotate, rotate, squeeze. The most important muscle to squeeze is that seat, that butt in the back. That's the top of your hip where your rotators happen. Squeeze it. Last time to the side. Rotate, rotate. Squeeze both sides. One more. Now left leg goes front. Flex. Now squeeze to turn out. One more. Go to the side. In front of the hip slightly. Standing tall as you can. Back. Light hands. Last time. Now to the side. Final direction. And close. Tendu. Close arms down to finish. Stand tall. Finish strong. Good. Okay. Let's move on to dégagé. Dégagé is like a tendu, just slightly off the floor. So with the right leg, we'll do. Yeah, so again, if you think you're going to kick the wall, kick something, turn one hand. Okay, with that right foot, let's go. Dégagé and close. In and in. Pique, pique, close, coupe, and close. What? Side and close, in and in. Pique, pique, close, coupe, and close. To the back. One slow, two quicker, or the accent changes. Pique, pique, close. Now this is a back coupe. That's the only time we're gonna do a back coupe. Then to the side, out. And close, and in, pique goes up, up, close, coupe, front, close. Then we'll do everything with the left leg. Okay, so this is a combination about timing, listening to your music, it's about accents. So the first dégagé you do, accent is out, the next two, the accent is in, then your piques. Pique, the accent goes up, up. Generally, pique always goes up, up. You always hit the floor, but the accent, that note that you want to hit, that sharp, the sharp note, up, up. And then we'll take that coupe front. So the only time you have your coupe back is when you're coming from the back. And remember, coupe back, it's your ankle connected to your ankle. Whereas coupe front, it's your toes connected to the ankle. One more thing, yeah, I talk about this a lot, is winging. So when you have a coupe back, notice my foot here is kind of sickled, but if you take those toes backwards, that's called the winging. Yeah, it's a beautiful position that we use in arabesque, and it's great to train as early as you can, yeah, wing those toes back. So notice my foot here. Doesn't look so good, right? We have to train those toes to go back a little bit. Okay, right and then left. We'll do that same pattern en quoi. Here we go. Right foot goes front and in, peek it up, up. Coupe front to the side. And in, peek it up, up. Coupe front. Now take it back. And in, peek it up, up. Coupe back. And last time side. In and in, up, up. Coupe front, now left side. Hold it, and in, pique, pique, coupe. Stand up taller. See if you can hear it for yourself. To the back, and in, coupe back. Toes last time. Coupe front. Okay, arms down. Okay, these are all steps that we should be familiar with. As you get more advanced in your classes, it's taking those same basic steps that you've known for years and putting them together in different ways. And also the connecting steps, how you get from one step to the next will become more and more difficult. But anytime you're doing a ballet dance, you're always gonna have some form of a tendu, some form of a dégagé, piqué, coupé is gonna happen, passé is gonna happen. So this is your groundwork. This is your foundation. These steps are gonna be with you the rest of your life, the rest of your dancing life and beyond. And all of that. Okay, let's move on to rond-de-jambe. I wanna do rond-de-jambe and then maybe a fondue as well. And then we'll come center and turn and jump and all that. So first position, right foot. We did this one on Monday, okay? This has gotten a little bit harder, the exercise. I think you can handle it. And I'm doing it with you. So if you, like the best way to learn is just to watch and repeat and follow. So that's exactly, we get this amazing opportunity now for you to just watch and repeat, yeah? Great, so with the right foot, we go. Plie the standing leg, stretch it back. You plie through first, again, stretch it back. Then you have four rond-de-jambe with regular tempo, 2, 3, 4. Again, we brush front and back and front and back, one more. Take it off the ground, rond-de-jambe en l'air, and close. Then you do the left side and around. Plié and around. 4, 3, 2, 1. Brush front, back, one more. Take it all the way around and close. That is your en dehors pattern. Now we're gonna reverse it and you're gonna start from the back. Back and front, back and front. 4, 3, 2, 1, brush, 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 brush off the floor. This is a great place to work on your turnout. Okay, don't give me this. yeah. Turn out your legs, stretch your legs straight, point your toes. Great opportunity there. So we do en dehors right, en dehors left, en dedans right, en dedans left. En dehors, en dedans are just referring to the direction. Is it front to back or is it back to front? You're always making that perfect half circle. I talk about it every time. Again, it's always gonna be ingrained. Directly in front of your nose to directly behind your spine. Through first, every time. Unless you're going back, behind your spine, front of your nose, straight through first. Hope I haven't confused you too much. Let's go. Rond-de-jambe. We're doing rond-de-jambe à terre and rond-de-jambe en l'air. What those words kind of sound like what they mean. À terre is on the earth, terre, and en l'air in the air. they kind of sound like what they mean. That's the nice thing. Ranajam, of course, means around the leg. Right leg, we go plie. Stretch it back, again, plie. Stretch it back. Four, three, two, one. Brushes front, back, front, back. One more. Hold that turnout. Slow, 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 slow. Work it, work it. Left side, plie. Stretch back, plie. Stretch back. You have your four, three, two. Hips stay forward. One. This is called your encloche or your balance walk. Three, four. One more. Take it all the way around. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Now right leg goes back. Plie. Take it around. En dedans. Again. Plie. Four rangs. Two. Three. Shoulders down. Four. En cloche. Through first position every time. Back. Front. One more. Hold that turnout. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Last time with the left leg. Back. Bring it forward. Back. Bring it forward. Four rangs. Back. Two. Three. Four. Brush it back. Front. Back. Front. One more. All the way around. Squeeze those legs. Arms down. Okay, good. So last thing we're gonna do at the bar is I made a decision today. I wanted to do something from fifth position because we've been working from first a lot. I wanna do fondue from fifth position. So we start with the right leg in front. Yeah, fifth, right foot in front. We're gonna take some fondue. So fondue means to melt. So both legs melt together, both legs extend and straighten together. So we're gonna go fondue, front coupe. Extend forward, fondue to the side. Now coupe fondue back, two brushes, brush, brush, reverse it. Fondue back, fondue side, fondue front, two brushes. And now, now we still have the right foot forward. So we're gonna do a little tag there. We're gonna go, let's go. Susu and hold. Passe and hold. Take it back and close. Now we have the other leg in front. Ha ha. Coupe to the front. Fondue to the side. Fondue to the back. Brush front. Brush back. Reverse. Fondue back. Fondue side. Fondue front. Brush brush. Now we have plie. Susu and hold. Passe and hold. Take it back and hold and close. Okay, again, if this is like way over your head, you've never done anything like this, just follow, just do your best, okay? Especially if you have one hand on the bar, just try to hold your tummy tight, okay? The more loosey-goosey you are, the harder it's gonna be to hold those positions, especially that passe en relevé, okay? We haven't been doing anything like that. So let's bump it up a notch. And I know Xander and Saoirse, I know you guys can do that. Let's do right foot in front, fondues. Okay, it's gonna be kind of quick. Oh, the other thing I wanted to mention, when you're doing fondue, especially from fifth, well, all the time fondue, you have to know whether your coupe is front or back. Okay, it's one of those things that will eventually come very, very naturally. Like I don't even have to think about it. I know exactly whether it's gonna be front or back. But for you guys learning it, you might have to think a little more about where the coupe is. So if we're going front, we have to do coupe front. There's no other way around it. Now, we're going from front to side, so we have to go from front coupe. Now, you're gonna go back next, so you have to anticipate. You have to bring it back, okay? Because if you came from front, that's cheating. That is totally cheating. So you have to bring it back first. Now, there's no other place to go except back coupe. I'm probably confusing you even more, but just follow along and try to take note of whether that coupe is front or back. Let's try it. Good luck. Right foot front, fifth position. Oh, no. Here we go. Right leg, fondue. Front, fondue. Side, fondue. Back two brushes. Reverse it. To the back, to the side, to the front two brushes. Good, now we susu. Squeeze your legs together, squeeze. Right leg goes straight up to passe. Hold it. Now take it back passe. Hold it. Slide to susu. Plie, maybe you step forward, left leg. Front and side. And back. Two brushes. Reverse. We go, susu, hold. Squeeze your legs. Left leg goes up to passe. Now switch it back passe. Slide it back down. Demi-plie, stretch. Oh boy, good work, good work. Let's take that support system away. And we are going to continue on in the center of the room. Okay, get some water. Take a mini water break. If you need it, yeah, it's a hot, hot day. Make sure you're staying hydrated. Yeah. I want to do some turning and we'll finish up with a little bit of jumping. Okay. So if you were here on Monday, we talked about spotting and we did some chaînées. We're gonna do the same thing today. First, let's talk about spotting. Even if you know what spotting is and you've done it a million times, I still wanna go over it again because it's that important. The reason you spot when you're doing a turn is so you don't get dizzy. You don't wanna just like go from spinning, get really dizzy and then you fall over and before you have to go into something complicated, yeah? So you don't want to be dizzy when you're turning. So spotting is a way to help. It's never going to work 100%. You're never going to not be like a tiny bit dizzy after you do a bunch of turns, but this will help so much. So let's start feet together, hands on your hips. So I want you to just look at the camera, like look at me, and you're going to start by turning your body. Your head stays looking at that camera. As soon as you can't see it anymore, boom, you flip back around. So you're facing, you're still looking at that same spot. Never lose sight of that spot. Like an owl, yeah, an owl's neck can go really far around. So you want to be careful not to tilt your head. Yeah, that's not gonna do anybody any good. So let's start, zip your feet together, hands on your hips, rise high onto your tippy toes. Just pick a direction, start to turn, tippy toes, and flip. Look and flip. Look and flip. Okay. Check in. How do you feel? Maybe a little dizzy. Hopefully not too much. If you're feeling really dizzy, just take a look at your palm, something that's not moving, and just look at it for a few seconds, and hopefully that will help a little bit as well. Although you can't really do that on stage. You turn, and then you just stand there and look. Yeah, so you just have to get more and more used to that feeling. Let's try the other direction, okay? So hands on your hips. Rise high on your tippy toes, and here we go. Look and flip. Look and flip. Look and flip. One more. Look and flip. Okay, good. If you need to look at your hand, look at your hand. So we're not always gonna have a screen to look at that makes it really easy. So generally, as a general rule of thumb, when you're dancing on stage or in your classroom, whichever direction you're going, that's the direction you're gonna be spotting. So if I'm doing a turn sequence from one corner to the other, from this way to this way, I'm gonna be looking where I'm going and I'm gonna be spotting in that general direction, okay? And another thing, you're not looking at something exactly specific. Like, I'm not looking directly at that door handle. I'm just looking in that general direction. Because when you're on stage and there's a bunch of lights on you and it's just the audience is black and you can't really see anything, you're not looking at a specific point. You're just looking in a general direction, okay? That's something important to know as well. But while you're starting out, if you have something in your line of view that's easy to spot, even better. Okay, so right now we're gonna go into chaînes. That's enough talking. We're gonna do chaînes right side. That's probably your more comfortable side. And then we'll try left side. So let's all go to this side of the room. And you're gonna go from this side to that side, straight across. No diagonals, nothing. So you're gonna look in that direction. So first thing you're gonna do, start in first position and tendu your right foot forward. Tendu your right foot forward. Now bring your arms to third, right arm is bent. I'm gonna show you the preparation, how you get into a chaîne turn. Oh, by the way, chaîne means chains. It's a chain link of turns. So it doesn't ever stop. It's a continuous turn that just keeps going. Believe it or not, it's one of the easier turns. So that's why we're starting with this one. The other thing is your position when you're turning, your arms are gonna stay in first, they don't move, and your feet will be in a high releve in first. And you're gonna be flipping, flip, flip, half turn, half turn, half turn, half turn, with your arms in first. And again, you're gonna be looking in the direction that you're going. I know it's a million things to think about, but that's why we're gonna start learning now. It might feel totally crazy and you have no idea what you're doing, but the more you try it, the easier it becomes. So just watch for a moment. I'm gonna look in the direction I'm going. I'm gonna bend my standing leg. For this very first one, I'm gonna open my arms for momentum and I'm gonna close them as I go into my chaîne. I wanna keep my feet as close as possible. They're gonna want to go wider. Really try to focus on squeezing those muscles like we talked about at bar and flipping, okay? The other thing is there are two ways to get into a chaîne. There's so many things to explain when you're just talking about a simple turn, but there are two ways. You can either pique onto that foot, pique onto it, stepping onto that releve, which is what we're gonna do. The other way, just so you know, is chasse to get into the chaîne turn, but we're not gonna do that today. We're gonna do pique, so you're gonna step onto that foot. We have pique here. This is also a pique. This is also a pique. There are many ways that we use that word. Enough talking, let's try it without music once and then we'll set it to music, okay? Right foot in front, right arm in front, bend your standing leg, look where you're going. Here we go. Open your arms and pique chaîne. Flip, 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 all the way till you get to the other side of the room. Ooh, I disappeared there. Okay, let's try it with music. You got this. You got it. Do some pirouettes. Pirouette music. Right foot front, plie, open the arms, and up, 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 da, 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 flip, 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 flip. Okay, good. I went too far. Woo, hope you don't feel too dizzy. Let's go back, do it one more time. On that right side, right foot front. Open the arms just on the first time. Here we go, look where you're going, and spot, 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 spot. I hope it went well. We're gonna try it on the other side. Yeah, this side might feel even more confusing and a little bit harder. For most people, left side feels harder. So let's go over to the other side of your room. We're gonna be turning now to the left. You're gonna be stepping on that left foot. So left foot front, so you can see me, left foot front, left arm front. Bend your standing leg, look where you're going. Open that arm, pique, and start spotting. Spot. Spot, spot. You're gonna turn to the left, that half turn, half turn. Okay, try it right now without music, just feel it in your body. Let's try it without music together. Plie, open and go. Flip, flip, flip. Okay, let's try with music. Good luck. turn, left. Yeah, until you hit the furniture. Look out. Good, let's try it one more time. One more time. Left foot in front, left arm bent. Bend your standing leg. Look where you're going. Here we go. Pique, chaîne. Flip, flip, flip. All right. This is the kind of thing you can practice on your own. The most important is your preparation. So I don't want you to just go straight into it, yeah? I want you to be methodical and really think about that setup. Your setup, your preparation is so important. That's why, I don't know if you've noticed this, but we always get four counts in the beginning of, oh, did we lose a friend? Oh yeah, maybe it was too hard. So you always get four counts for nothing, okay? That is your chance to prepare whatever you're about to do. Ballet is very nice, it gives you that four counts. We're basically out of time. I wanted to do one last thing. We don't have time to jump, but I wanted to do a prep for another turn, but not turn it today. Okay, maybe next week we'll get into the turn, maybe. So let's go back to this side. This is getting you ready for a pique turn. This is one of my very favorite turns to do. It is a turn, well, we're not gonna turn it today, but it is a turn on one leg, and it has the same preparation as a chaîne. So if we come back over here, right foot in front, right arm bent, bend that standing leg, look to where you're going. You're gonna open your arms and you're gonna step on that leg that goes out and you're gonna bring that other leg into a back passe. Open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close, okay? And for today, while we're learning it, that right leg is just gonna go out. You're just gonna step onto that straight leg each time, out. Brush it out to the side. Your left leg will come to back passe. Arms will open and close, open and close. Let's give it a try without music. It's a lot of coordination again. So right foot front, right arm bent, bend your standing leg, open that arm, up, brush, up, brush, up, brush, up. It's almost like you're replacing that standing leg. You're replacing that leg with your other leg. This leg that goes out, the right leg, is a peg leg. It never bends. It just stays straight. You just go up to it. So again, like we talked about pique chaîne, this is a pique turn. It's a prep for a pique turn. So just watch for a moment. Back passe, replace it. Back passe, replace it. In and out, in and out. Let's try it once with music and then you're done. We're not even gonna do the other side today because it's a lot of coordination. So let's just focus on that good side, on that right side. Go to that first music. Okay. Here we go. Get ready. Right foot front. Bend and up and up and up. Brush in. Okay. That's a little bit. Let's do a little slower. That's too fast. Here we go. That's too slow. Okay, there's no good music for this. Let's do ones without music to finish, okay? Last thing. So tendu front, bend that standing leg. Here we go. And for this, just keep your gaze forward. Keep your gaze on the camera so you can see what I'm doing and just follow along, okay? Here we go. And open, close, open, close. Brush passe, brush passe. Replace it. Okay, it's a turn, it's a travels from side to side. And eventually that turn is gonna look like this. turn and turn. And you can just keep doing as many of those as you want. It's a really fun turn. It's called a pique turn. It's the only turn I can think of that you have a back passe. Okay, most pirouettes, you have your passe front. This one is back passe. Okay, we are out of time. Thank you so much. I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day, wonderful rest of your week. I hope to see you guys back soon. Remember, there is class, this same class on Monday and Wednesday. Enjoy. All right. Have a great rest of your day. Bye, everyone.